morning. Today I am going to demonstrate a ring counter experiment. For this experiment, we need the components. So, the following components are IC7495, one number, connecting box, and then the instruments are digital IC burner. Take the IC and fix it in the burner. This is the ring circuit, logic diagram circuit. In this circuit, P0 to P3 is parallel input data and Q0 to Q3 is serial output data. So, connect pin number 1. Connect pin number 1 of the IC to Q3. Q3 is connected to pin number 10. So connect pin number 1 to pin number 10. Again this 10 is connected to the Q3. Pin number 10, again it is connected to the Q3. So 10 to Q3. In this is Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3. Then pin number 2 is connected to the P0, parallel input data. Pin number 2 is connected to the P0. So connect pin number 2 to P0. In this is P0, P1, P2 and P3. So pin number 3 is connected to the P1. Connect pin number 3 to P1. Pin number 4 is connected to the P2. Connect pin number 4 to P2. Pin number 5 is connected to the P3. Connect pin number 5 to P3. Connect pin number 6 to mode control. So connect pin number 6 to mode control. This is the mode control. Connect pin number 7 to ground. So pin number 7 is connected to the ground. Pin number 8 is clock 2 and pin number 9 is clock 1. Now short pin number 8 and 9. Short pin number 8 and 9 and connect it to the clock. You are shorted clock 1 and clock 2. That means pin number 8 and 9 short together and then it is connected to the clock. So pin number 10 we are already connected Q3. Pin number 11 is connected to the Q2. Connect pin number 11 to Q2. Pin number 12 is connected to the Q1. Connect pin number 12 to Q1. So pin number 13 is connected to the Q0. Connect pin number 13 to Q0. Pin number 14 is connected to the VCC. So connect pin number 4 to VCC. C switch on the digital timer. Make this mode control high. Make sure that this mode control should be in high position, and then give the parallel input data. Now we are given the parallel input data is 1000, 1000, and then afterwards place this clock. So we are given 1000. So the output is 1000. Whatever the input we are given, it will be obtained here after pressing the clock. Then keep the mode control in zero position, that means low position. Then press this clock. If you press the clock, one bit will be shifted. Previous it is 1000. Now the second position is 0100. So the output is 0100. If you press another one clock, so the output is 0010. So the output is 0010. Again you press the clock, so the output is 0001. The output is 0001. Again if you press, the sequence will repeat like this.